100 watts of power, dudes. Okay, we're gonna do this in the road quickly. I've gone ahead and spent a little bit more money for a little less power output. You pay a little more, you get a lot more for your money. So if you set 100 watts on the box, that's what you get as well. If you've been on the channel before, you'll understand that I am the one who goes for the Chinese cheap stuff to try it out, see if it works properly. Most of the time it does not, so it might not surprise you, or it will, to see this here. Let's have a look. Comes in a lovely, very sturdy case, got to say that. So there it is, carry handle. We unlatch this and look what's inside. There's your, I think they're called MC4 connectors. That's pretty cool. Got a nice screen here. It's got a nice little stand here. These are quite substantial. And this side, that should work. We connect it up. Eagle-eyed among you might have seen that there is a plug on the other side of this cable. This is not how it came in the box. Plug it in. Now we're operating. On the back of here, we have this display. You can see 12.6 volts. That's the battery amount of power in the battery at the moment. This is the amount of solar going in. And that's your total amperage hours of how much you've charged the battery with since you plugged it in. We've only got 0.8 amps here, and that's because we're in the shade. It's very dappled. So if I move it into the clear sunlight, we check again, suddenly we've got 4.7 amps. And if you angle it towards the sun, that's pretty cool. I like this little readout. So now we're getting 4.9 amps, which is pretty good. It's only 100 watts. And that means you've only got 6 amps total maximum, which is probably not a lot, but it should be enough to run your fridge and charge your laptop. So basically that's all you need mostly. It's quite heavy, but it's substantial. It's got nice plastic corners to protect it. It's got the little angled pieces over here, which you can adjust, maybe light all the way flat even if the sun is overhead, and also trying to line it up with the sun. What we do see is some solar panels, if you obscure one or two panels in the shade, it will lose all its power. In this case, if I put my hand here, we lose this much. And there's back to 4.8. So if you obscure a little bit, you lose some power coming in, but you don't lose all of your power, which is really cool. And I think that's the difference, is the quality of the solar panels itself that allows you to get as much power as you can. Since I've been talking, we've done 0.1 amp hour charge into the battery. Battery is now 13.2. There's our wattage, and if you go over it with your hand, you can see how it affects it. But you're still getting some charge even though you're in the shade. That's nice that you don't have to lean it against something. You can move it around. It doesn't need to be against the car. You can find the sun. Also, let's have a look at what I've done with the battery section. So some of you might be thinking, what is this now? Well, as I've just mentioned, you get 6 amps of power out of a 100 amp panel. Most of these plugs are rated for 16 amps. So this is never going to be overloaded at all. So a lot of you might be wondering, why did I cut these off? What are they doing off here? Well, the point is it's under your seat. You don't want to have to take your seat out, remove this, clip it all on, move your solar panel outside, and then wait for it to charge, come back in here, unclip it all, close this again, put your seat back. This little bad boy, it's already there. Everything's connected permanently to the battery. Come in here, clip it in, and you're done. Let me know down below if you're in agreement with the way I'm doing it. It's worked so far. We've been charging it for a couple of weeks. No worries at all. Here's our double battery system. This one is for the car itself. This is our leisure battery, 120 watts. This one is quite heavy. I'll show you where I got it. I'll put a link down below. It's the best one so far, because the one Achilles heel with the solar panel system is your battery storage, which is not so cool. You have to spend a bit of money on your batteries too, which I haven't done in the past. The Ledger battery is also connected to our main battery by this bad boy, and that charges from your main battery. When your alternator is charged, your main battery, and it's full, it releases this like a switch, and then it'll start charging your Ledger battery as well. So in that respect, I hope if we're on the road a lot, we can keep the battery charged, and when you're parked up for a day or two, you use your Renogy solar panel to charge up the battery again. So far, I'm very impressed with the quality of it compared to what we've been using in the past. That's on me. I would recommend it definitely. 6 amps might not sound a lot. It's quite a heavy, bulky case, but padding, very good. I've had this thing bang into the corner of a chest or something, and nothing's happened. This is very cool quality. That's quite heavy for what it is, 100 watts, but it's gonna last longer. That's the hope anyway. I hope you've learned something out of this. Maybe it's been informative, who knows. Thanks for watching, guys. Let me know down below what your experiences are with the solar panels in general, especially with the Renogy. So far, I'm gonna give this a massive thumbs up. You pay a little more, you get a lot more for your money. So let me know what you think to the crocodiles, man. Catch you next time. Thanks for watching. Keep rolling.